गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू माय चैनल द इनविजिबल ट्रेडर। वीडियोस अगर आपको अच्छे लगते हैं तो लाइक कमेंट शेयर कीजिए और बाकी लोगों को हमारे साथ जोड़िए। लेट अस हैव अ क्विक रिव्यू दैट व्हाट वी टोल्ड इन मार्केट यस्टरडे एंड व्हाट हैपेंड एंड देन क्विकली टू कम टू टुमारोस ट्रेडिंग। ओके, नाउ ऑनेस्टली यू गाइस टेल मी हाउ मेनी यूट्यूबर्स टोल्ड यू दैट 37,000 से मार्केट गिरेगा, राइट? How many people? I don't know. I have looked at probably while sleeping yesterday a couple of YouTube videos. Big players were telling that 37,000 say market might fall. What was our view? I mean, if people watch, right? I mean, I have warned people. See, the way the entire week, let's do a quick spend 2 minutes how we have traded this entire week. What I told on the Sunday weekly video, I have very clearly told the way market behaving Bank Nifty especially, and I told especially Bank Nifty, right? The way market is behaving, market is in strength. It is going to make a bull run, but will not be an ultra bull. That's what I said. Will not be an ultra bull, provided that Tuesday we get a red candle, right? That was the view, and I said that Monday closing that we will wait and then we will make our positional view. Okay, we could have sold PE actually, not an issue. But rather than selling PE, you will never sell ITMP, of course, would not have given you much money the way the buying would have given. This is ultra move trending. I mean, after Sitaraman candles, I think, and one more move that happened a few months back, this is the third biggest move that I'm seeing in Bank Nifty, almost 80 degrees low, continuously for 4 days, 3 days, right? And I very clearly told that we have to respect this breakout. Market is in strength. Yes, Monday we did not expect 1,000 point move. Market went up. Tuesday, I said market will be consolidated if Tuesday we see a red candle. Tuesday we did not, because the move was so high, because our level was here, right? The consolidation has to start here, but it did not happen. That's the reason I told Tuesday you have to take a C, ideally BTST. Yesterday also I told don't take PEBTST, market will go upside, and I told you in yesterday's video, if this price action happens, on Monday evening I told, if this price action happen, Wednesday B you can take CEBTST, right? That is the statement I made. How many people paid attention to that or not? The reason I did not take a CEBTST today, because everybody knows that I did not trade today in the morning because of other walks, right? This is the reason, because if you're not at the desk, you should not take CBTS, right? I came to the market at 3 o'clock, around this much, right? But yesterday we made good money. Today also, during only within 20 minutes, we made around 22,000-23,000 rupees, right? Within this move. I imagine if you would have taken the CBTST, I could have easily made actually 2 lakhs plus, right? But anyway, that's called luck. So, but what we told in yesterday's videos is ideally this level, right? What I told, if market is coming down or gapping down, we'll see an extremely range bound scenario. If market is gapping up above this level, then we'll see a volatile market. This volatile market did not happen. That is where our like analysis might have gone wrong. But what I said, this sell zone would be a touch and sell kind of stuff like yesterday, like this, right? But it did not happen because the candle was so furious. Not a single red candle sustaining below this level, even for 2 minutes. Okay, not a single red candle in 5 minute time frame sustaining above this level for 2 minutes. Forget about 10, 15 minutes. I'm talking about 2 minutes. Everybody knows how we trade the sell zone. I put it in the group, in the chat and all those. That whenever you have a sale zone support, boom, 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 aapki buying yahan pe honi chahiye. Okay, aapki buying, your buying should have been here ideally, and you would have been trailed, you would have been taking enough money from market. Okay, this buying was guaranteed anyway from here to here, right? Everybody knows how to trade the sale zone trading. And here also, the second buying would have been here to here, at least trailing, right? I traded only this zone where the 22,000 rupees has been made. But I do a larger quantity in a small time. It was scalping in the morning. If it would have traded, I would have taken this buying in the morning. And I would have taken this buying also, because this is a pattern which has given us like hell lot of money. I don't know how many times this pattern gave us so much of confident money. And almost every time almost on the buying side. But anyway, how many people learn from the video and they apply, I don't know, but my view was very, very clear, right? Correct. Weekly view has a had a caveat, and we never take a PBTST in this entire week. Okay. Anyway, now Nifty May, if you come back, Nifty May, my capping was 940, 17,700 straddle wala ko maine bola tha. 940 mein you can do an adjustment if required. Market might go to 18,050, but you can start your straddle adjustment at here. Okay. You can actually open up a strangle, or ideally you can add one more leg to this. I don't know how many people did this, but if you look at Nifty was capped here. Nifty mein maine kya bola tha? This is a big buy zone. I would wait for this level, and but market can give you a buying from 17,750. This is the statement I made, but I will not take that buy. Okay, because it was a risky buy. Okay, so Nifty was confusing. I mean, personally, if market me hota, I would not have bought it here. I would have bought market Nifty here. Okay, 17,850 to this level, 920, around 60, 70 points buying. I would have done this. This buying, I would have definitely would have taken. Okay, because this is ideally second leg buying. Swing high is getting cut. And sorry for the background noise, and swing high is getting cut, and our max cap level was this. Okay. Anyway, Nifty traded in our zone wonderfully, no doubt about that. Okay. But how many people traded in Nifty? I don't know, but Bank Nifty would have been a wonderful trading today. Anyway, forget about today, tomorrow, kal kya hoga? Let us look at the data a little bit. First of all, option chain ka data, aaj agar dekhenge, BISY ka. Right. So if you look at client has sold index futures, okay, that means they are bearish, and all the other institutions have bought index futures. We're talking about futures. Okay. That means futures mein client is bearish, everybody else is bullish. Clear, everybody? Right. Now look at the stock futures. Stock future mein everybody is bearish and client is bullish. Okay. Client is bullish. Where you pay more attention, whether it is the stock future or is the index future, that you will pay more attention. Okay, that is important thing, and that's a trick where your analysis will come out of it. Okay, now I'll keep that to the last. Now looking at to the derivative option ka segment, pros have 111,000 call short, 100,000 put short. It's a range bound position. FI doesn't have any position. Okay, index future mein long, but more than that stock future mein short. Okay, ye to aise bhi zyada buy kar nahi rahe. Index mein client is heavily bullish, but they have similar amount of put also. Okay, similar amount of put also. Diagram position to koi maine nahi rakhta ideally. Okay, so from this data, what do you think who is going to become much heavier in the market? Everybody knows that on an expiry day, the pros becomes really heavy. Okay, they are really powerful. They are a hulk of the market on a Thursday. Okay, especially when their entire position is against ideally the client's positions. Okay, if you look at the entire position, so fight bit is between pros and clients only. Okay, index call is short, index put is short, both are short. It might be a perfect expiry. That should be our view. Okay, it might be a perfect expiry. That should be our view. Coming to the index future, since there is some position on the buying side, in the morning we might see ideally a little bit positive side. A little bit positive side, but not that big. Okay. A little bit positive side. And you will see that stock index heavyweight specific stocks moving in the morning. Agar, how do you analyze from this data? If only index heavyweights are going upside in the morning, that means that move is to support this index future bull position, and they will be cut off. They will be cut off. Okay. So with that view, what we are saying is tomorrow, looking at the data, looking at the label, tomorrow market would be upside capped. Okay. Tomorrow market would be upside capped. We told that for yesterday also, like for today's trading, ideally we thought that it will be here capped, but it did not happen. And it happened after 11. So generally the option chain data, I already told you there are three timings I look at for the option chain data development. One is around 11 to 11:30. One is around 150 to 145. And then last is around 245, 230 to 245. So tomorrow you just need to pay. We will go to the market with a view of a perfect expiring. if market opens flat, almost 90% sure market is going to be a perfect expiry and strangle is going to work. Okay, as simple as that. Second thing is that market view is upside cap, but you have to pay attention the option chain data development between 11 to 11:30. If put writers becoming heavy, okay, then this upside capping view may not work also. Okay, so only caveat is that 11 to 11:30. Main dekhta hun live agar if I can help. Otherwise, that is the time period we will just once look at the option chain data. Okay, otherwise with that view, let us go for a view of 18,030 would be my capping on Nifty. And the group may be bola 18,050 would be my capping for tomorrow. So 18, the market agar flat open hota hai bhaisa, so you can immediately start the strangle of 18,050 to 17,850. So 200 point ga strangle, 200 point, okay? 200 point ga strangle, 17,850 and 18,050. Ye zero hona chahiye, C and P dono. Maine kal bhi aapko video mein bola tha, अगर आपकी किस्मत अच्छा है तो मार्केट 17,700 पे एक्सपायर करेगा अराउंड दैट. इफ यू हैव ए बैड लक, मार्केट विल एक्सपायर अराउंड 17,850. ओके, सो मार्केट देखो, मार्केट में एक्सपायर अराउंड 17,900, डजंट मैटर, बट माय व्यू इज 17,850 पी टुमारो शुड बी जीरो इफ मार्केट इज ओपनिंग फ्लैट. And 18,050 C should be zero if market is opening flat. Strangle चालू करेंगे, उसके बाद adjustment देखेंगे. Thursday expiry day है. Buying हम सिर्फ scalping ही करेंगे, only scalping. Otherwise we will paint basically selling positions mostly. Okay. Downside में मेरी capping जो है 17,850 का ही है. यहाँ पे buy level आपको दिख रहा होगा, swing high दिख रहा होगा. यहाँ पे अगर मार्केट आया तो आप एक बाइंग स्कैल्पिंग बाय ले सकते हो. स्टॉप लॉस स्ट्रिक्टली इन सिस्टम, 30 पॉइंट का स्टॉप लॉस आपका होना चाहिए, 820 का स्टॉप लॉस. ओके, 850 से बाय करोगे, 820 का स्टॉप लॉस लोगे और उसके साथ बाय करोगे. व्यू, क्योंकि व्यू ये है कि मार्केट विल नॉट फॉल बिग. मैंने तो कल भी बोला था आपको कि मार्केट मे नॉट फॉल बिग, अपर साइड में विल नॉट फॉल बिग. अपर साइड में वोलाटाइल हो सकता है, ये तो ऊपर ही चला गया, बट मार्केट विल नॉट फॉल बिग. टुमारो ऑल्सो द सेम थिंग, मार्केट विल नॉट फॉल बिग. 17,850 से बाइंग चालू कर सकते हैं और मार्केट अगर 18,030 के आसपास पहुंच जाता है, वी कैन स्टार्ट ए सेल, बट ऑल दिस बाइंग ऑफ सी एंड सेलिंग ऑफ पी वुड बी स्कैल्पिंग. दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू ट्रेल फास्ट बिकॉज दिस इज एक्सपायरी. ओके, सो मेरा रेंज ये है निफ्टी का. कल ओपन हुआ तो स्ट्रैंगल करेंगे, गैप अप हुआ तो वी विल वेट. प्राइस एक्शन सिर्फ सेकंड लेग पे ही आपको सेल लेना है, चाहे कितना भी छोटा प्रॉफिट हो. ओके, फर्स्ट टच में नहीं, इट वुड बी रिस्की. टुडे पीपल वर ट्राइंग टू आस्क वेदर वी शुड सेल सी और नॉट, राइट? आई सेड इट माइट बी अ लिटिल बिट रिस्की बिकॉज यू डोंट नो वेयर मार्केट विल ओपन. इफ यू लुक एट नासडैक इज स्टिल नेगेटिव. कल जैसे मैंने बोला था आईटी गिरेगा, आज देखो आईटी कितना गिरा. आईटी, if you look at IT, is like everybody is up, IT is like 2% down. I already clearly told you yesterday IT is going to fall. Tomorrow also IT is not going to make any big moves. Rather than we will see a downside, that itself will limit Nifty. Okay, Bank Nifty agar aap dekhoge 1000 point ki movement, but Nifty mein only 120 point movement because Nifty IT was falling like 800 points. Okay, the same thing will happen tomorrow. So Nifty mein to binda strangle chalega. बैंक निफ्टी में देखते हैं. बैंक निफ्टी में माय अपर साइड कैपिंग टुमारो इज अराउंड 38,300. सो दैट मींस मार्केट अगर फ्लैट ओपन होता है ना तो 38,200 का सी और मार्केट इस लेवल के नीचे जाएगा, मुझे नहीं लगता. सो 37,300 का पी, सो दिस इज लाइक 900 पॉइंट का रेंज, बट यू विल गेट गुड प्रीमियम. ओके, वट एवर प्रीमियम यू विल गेट, इट विल बी गुड. सो ये दोनों का स्ट्रैंगल आप कर सकते हो. Then we can do an adjustment. So range जो है almost 800 point का range है. Okay, ये 350 actually. 800 point का मेरा range है अगर market flat open होता है. Market अगर gap up open होता है तो we have a sell position around 38,300, 280 के आसपास. ये भी scalping में ही अपन करेंगे या फिर आप C sell कर सकते हो. ठीक है, कल मैंने data भी आपको दिखाया, analysis भी दिखाया. Unless 11:30 में option chain data is heavily changing, and a good development is happening on the PE sorting side, market would be range bound. Tomorrow you might see Bank Nifty working in this range. Just smaller range, bigger range thoda bada hai, but Bank Nifty working in this range. Is it going to fall big? Absolutely no. Don't think of taking a PE jackpot unless market is at this level and it is around 1130. Everybody is clear. Tab jaake PE ban sakta hai. Matlab ek ghante mein market girega, 300-400 point market girne ki possibilities hai. Only in that case. Otherwise, don't look for a PE jackpot tomorrow. And Friday ko aapko C nahi lena. Maine already bol diya. Friday we may see a good sell. Okay, so do not take any positions of C on Friday. For Friday. ठीक है, थैंक यू वेरी मच. वीडियो थोड़ा सा लंबा हो गया, बट जय माता दी, गुड नाइट. बाकी लाइव में देखें.